Brutal police tactics captured on camera. A taxi driver, believed to be Mozambican, is handcuffed to the back of a South African police van near Johannesburg. He was apparently illegally parked. Police say they tried to get him to remove his car, but he attacked them and took one of their guns. The officers at the scene called for backup, and then this. In broad daylight, dozens of witnesses looking on, including the person who recorded this, the man is dragged for several hundred meters. He's injured but is not taken to hospital. A few hours later on Tuesday, he dies in a police cell from suspected head wounds.
We are shocked by this incident.
The Police Investigative Directorate is an independent government body that probes criminal offences committed by the police.
And we deal with many other incidents which don't make it to the media, but the important thing, I think, is that they are investigated.
Dlamini says the directorate received more than 6,000 complaints accusing police officers of everything from murder to torture last year. This dramatic shootout shocked the world when police killed 34 platinum miners on a wildcat strike in August. The president ordered a judicial investigation into the event. The year before that, this man was shot at during a protest in full view of the media. He died at the scene. Amnesty International says this incident is the latest in an increasingly disturbing pattern of brutal police conduct in South Africa.
What does this say about the South African police?
It's not a reflection on the police service as a whole, because we know, for instance, of many other officers who are dedicated, who do their job, who uphold the law and who catch criminals all the time.
The South African National Police Commissioner has strongly condemned the incident and has pledged to cooperate with the probe. The police refused to be interviewed by CNN. Nkepile Mabuse, CNN, Johannesburg.